Good morning, everybody. Ian Gilder from TV Travel Shop, and do I have some deals for you? Like, if it's your first time, I'd like to welcome you to the show. The show is very similar every day. I come to you at 11 o'clock with three amazing offers. They're going to be a short haul, a long haul, or either a cruise, a bucket list, or sporting event. They get submitted to us by our trade partners, whether they're tour operators or travel agents. The team who have a woolly mammoth amount of experience to check these to make certain they are great deals. They also make certain that your money is protected by the way of either Truss, ABTA or ATA. Well, obviously with COVID at this precise moment, you want to know that you're booking with a reputable company. On to our short haul offer, and this one is absolutely cracking. It comes from our friends at WWTT Deals. And this is one of the cheapest deals that we've featured in absolutely ages, and I really, really like this one. This one is a Christmas market holiday for, obviously, November and December 2021 to the wonderful city of Prague. Prague is very, very popular. It has some stunning architecture, lovely squares, and they hold some of the best Christmas markets around the world. Every one of their squares, it has a market in there. It's all lit up, it's all festive, it's Oompa Loompa bands, it's Glühwein, it's Budvar. It's everything you'd actually expect from a Christmas market. And as I say, my friends at WWTT Deal have put in an amazing, amazing offer. So where you can spend either two or three nights over the festive period. So you can go and see what has to offer. As I say, there's lots of markets there, there's different stalls, you can buy yourself decorations, you can do a bit of shopping, you can do some cooking. It's just so much to see and do. And this is staying at the four-star Hotel Ada on a B&B basis. On TripAdvisor, it's rated 256 out of 674 hotels in Prague. It gets a four-star rating. It's a traveler's choice accommodation as well. So we know that when we research stuff, that we're putting you into decent hotels, because we don't want complaints as advertisers, and certainly our travel agent partners don't want them either. The hotel is situated in an attractive area overlooking all of Prague. It's just a 5 subway stop from Wenceslas Square, Prague's main boulevard, with many shops, restaurants and open air markets. All the rooms come with the usual safe, mini bar, all en suite, mini fridge, satellite TV, radio. It also has a casino which offers fun and entertainment, so hopefully you can win your money back. Dining facilities include a restaurant, a dining room, a breakfast room and a bar. But at the end of the day, you're going to be out, literally it'd be nice and cold, nice and fresh, getting your Glühwein and just taking in the sights and sounds. So if you fancy a little bit of Prague for Christmas market, how much is this going to cost you? Are you ready for this? My friends at WWTT are doing two nights from only £129. That's flying from London or Manchester. Or you can go for three nights from only £149 per person. If I was going to go, I'd pay the extra £20 and do the extra night. That includes your flights and you either two or three nights on a B&B basis. So if you fancy a bit of Prague Christmas markets, fancy a bit of Budvar, going around, seeing the Christmas trees, the lights, the festivities, phone the guys at WWTT Deals, numbers on the screen, like it and share it on Facebook, give it some Instagram love. Sign up to our YouTube channel and enable your notifications. And the good news I've also been told is once they get to 1,000 likes on Facebook, we'll be doing a live draw, and one of you lucky viewers are going to have a two-night break away courtesy of TV Travel Shop. On to our long haul offer, and we're going to a place which we feature quite regularly, good old Dubai. This comes from Hology, the 4 and 5 star travel experts, and this is for a brand new hotel in Dubai. Dubai, if you've never been, is a vast metropolis. It's sprawling, it's getting bigger, it's very, very expensive, but the quality is some of the best in the world. You're guaranteed stunning weather, food's exceptional, beaches are beautiful, and it's literally, if you want the best of the best, Dubai is arguably some of the best of the best. And this is for the brand new hotel, the Hotel Rio Dubai, which is a 4-star. What makes this different, which you don't get many in Dubai, it is an all-inclusive hotel. So it includes all your drinks and it's 24 hours. So literally you can eat and drink to your heart's content. If you've never been to Dubai, there's only one thing that is cheap in Dubai, and that's petrol. So taxis are cheap. Everything else is very, very expensive. So if you're at a normal hotel, a bottle of beer is going to cost you £10. a glass of wine or a spirit, a mixer, it's going to cost you £20. You can't nip down Tesco's and buy them. It's a very, very expensive place. If you like a drink, this all-inclusive hotel makes it excellent value for money. So, Hology put a deal together, which is for 5 nights between the 1st and 24th of November. And as I say, it's all-inclusive with direct flights with Emirates from Gatwick. You can go from Manchester or Glasgow as well. And at this precise moment, it has a saving of up to £515 per person. I'm not going to quite give you the price just yet. I'm just going to say it saves £515. Opened in 2020, and as I said, it's all-inclusive, and it's open 24 hours a day. It's situated in Deer Island, which is like a suburb outside Dubai. It's 11 kilometres from the airport, free Wi-Fi, has main and theme restaurants, three swimming pools, and a children's pool with water supplied. It also has a Splash Water World water park with water slides. It's on the beach, includes your entertainment. It's a really, really good hotel. But what else is there to see and do in Dubai? If I was going to Dubai, first thing I would do is go into the main part of town, get myself up the Burj Khalifa Tower. It's the world's tallest building, it's over a kilometre high. Speak to the guys at Hology, they can pre-book your ticket because there's going to be nothing worse. You turning up, it's 85 degrees and you're going to have to queue, so pre-book your ticket. Other things you can do, you can go to the Burj Al Arab, which is the sale hotel which everybody's seen. Next door to that is the Madinat, so if you want to go out and have some food and shopping, it has 120 different restaurants. You've got, if you want a bit of water park action, you've got the Wild Woody Water Park. You've also got Aqua Adventure at Atlantis. There is a couple of theme parks. I think it's DreamWorks, which is like an MGM type of thing as well. Other things I would do is I'd get myself out in the evening. I'd mostly take a desert safari. They take you out by 4x4. They go around the sand dunes. They throw you around. It's good fun. You then end up in a Bedouin camp where you get a belly dance. You can do camel riding. You have a barbecue. You can do some sandboarding, smoke some shisha, get a henna tattoo. You can go loads of shopping. There's some great shopping malls. If you fancy it, you can go skiing in one of the malls. That's really, really good fun. The ski lift is pretty slow though. That's indoors. It's proper snow as well, which is absolutely unbelievable. So if you want to go to Dubai, which many people do, I've told you a little bit about the hotel, how much is it going to cost me? If you go from London, and so London is at 949 per person, Manchester and Glasgow at 999, say brand new hotel, saving of £515 per person. Cracking deal, brand new. From the guys and girls at Hology, numbers on the screen. Like it and share it on Facebook. Give us some Instagram love. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Enable notifications to see yours truly at 11 o'clock, giving you the best travel deals and inspiration in the travel marketplace. Onto my favourite section of the show. Is it a cruise? Is it a bucket list? Or is it a sporting event? The cruises keep on coming, and this comes from the Six Star Club. So the Six Star Club are a premium luxury cruise club, so they only feature 5 and 6 star cruises. And this is an amazing offer on one of the most iconic and most famous cruise ships afloat, which is the Cunard Line Queen Victoria. I was very fortunate enough to go on the naming ceremony on her, which I must say is around about 8 to 10 years ago. One of the most beautiful ships that I've actually ever been on. Obviously Cunard is 5 star plus, it's similar to White Star Service. It's some of the best that you're liable to get. Very quintessentially British. But I think the video which we're gonna put on will explain it a lot better than myself.
Welcome aboard. Thank you.
Doesn't that look amazing? So if you like White Star service, afternoon tea, absolutely amazing dining, quality, this could be the holiday for you. So where are you going? This is basically on the 1st of December this year, so obviously everybody's chomping at the bit to get away, and hopefully cruises will be back, so in a safe environment. And the offer is for a 12-night cruise down to the Canaries, so get yourself down to the sun, top up your tan, make yourself feel better, get yourself in the spa, and literally just get yourself pampered. And the price that the Six Star Club have given is absolutely amazing. But let me tell you where it's going first of all. First port of call is going to be Madeira. A place that I've never been, but it's famous for a few things. Obviously Madeira cake, I've eaten plenty over the years. Madeira wine, you can go to the Botanical Gardens, or something which is really cool and quirky. Madeira is kind of, Funchal is quite a hilly town. So many people walk up and then they have like what they call like a toboggan on wheels, which they push through the cobble streets, like it's cross between a toboggan and a gondola. So you've got a man steering it, coming down. It's like a bit of a thrill ride. Meant to be really, really great fun. So if you fancy a little bit of that, that could be something that you could do. Next port of call is a little island of La Palma. It's not particularly well known to us Brits, but it's a stunning Canary island. Nowhere near as commercialised as Tenerife and Gran Canaria and Lanzarote. So go there, have a literally cup of coffee, a beer, bit of a chill. Next port of call is Gran Canaria, so you can go things like to Maspalomas sand dunes, again go to the beaches, just have a nice easy day. Then on to one of my favourite places in the Canaries, which is Lanzarote. What would I do in Lanzarote? There's only one thing for me to do in Lanzarote, and that's get yourself up Mount Tiemann Fire. Mount Tiemann Fire is an active volcano. The island is predominantly black sand, due to it's where it spilled many, many, many years ago. And take the tour around there. And I found it intriguing, must be 20 years ago. I really, really enjoyed it. They do lots of little experiments and tricks with you. So they'll like pour some water in a hole and all of a sudden it will spout out like a geyser. They'll put some straw in a hole. That will just all of a sudden spontaneously combust. And they do some really, really good cooking up there as well. They literally cook on the volcano, have a big grill, and literally it's 40 foot above, and it cooks the food absolutely stunningly. And at the same time, they then take you out on a coach tour, which will take you around where it's all sort of, it's literally like a scene from Planet of the Apes, and where it's all spewed over, and where all the molten lava was. It's just a really, really good day out. That would be my number one tip for Lanzarote. And then your last port of call before coming back into Southampton is good old Lisbon. Lisbon, beautiful city, it's a place that I've been to once, lovely old town, very, very, very similar to San Francisco, quite hilly, you can take a tram, they've got a lovely bridge which you can walk across, a bit like the Golden Gate, it's just literally cobbled streets, it's just very quirky, very fresh, very funky, it's just a lovely, lovely place to visit before getting back on your cruise and coming back to Southampton. As I say, it's 5-star, it's 12 nights on board. It includes all your food, it includes your port taxes, it includes your entertainment. You're going to have a Broadway show every night, you're going to have dance classes, you're going to have lectures, you've got a casino, you've got a spa, there's so much to see and do. And this is an absolutely stonking deal. The price was £1,249, but the guys and girls at the Six Star Club are leading in for an inside cabin at only £1,078. For an extra 90, so 1,168, you can go to an outside. Or you can go to a balcony from only £1,325 per person. So if you want to try cruising, quintessentially British, in which when you want the best, it's very relaxed, it only holds 2,000 people, so it's not one of the mega liners, but so you've got more space, it's 5-star, beautiful, beautiful ship. Give the guys and girls a call at the 6-star Club, numbers on the screen. Like it and share it on Facebook, give us some Instagram love. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, enable notifications to see me at 11 o'clock giving you some travel inspiration and the best travel deals in the marketplace. See you all tomorrow at 11 o'clock, and please stay safe.